I just want to do a quick, for maybe the people who came after Sidi Hamza started, and also just to have a little summary of the two, just the main ideas that I took note of. In Sidi Hamza's speech, we could say that dunya is no home for the heart, for the ruh, and that the greater or most noble quest is the search for the knowledge of the Creator and the relationship with Him, which is the same quest as the quest for our own identity, going from passive to productive, and that progress is not what we think it is in terms, and what we see in the media and so on, what we hear about. It's not something going always forward. Some things from the past are also the traditional knowledge, heritage can be also even a greater progress. And just a quick summary. Do you want to add something up? Yes?
Of course. One of the things I think that's important about that is that even experientially, we think that progress is happening because we're growing. As an individual, we are developing, we're learning new things, we're getting older, we're going from being a student to working, we're getting a new job, getting a promotion. And so there's a sense of progress moving forward. But we also know the arc of life has another side, that we have a type of progress, and then we get old. And we can't run as fast, we can't jump as high, we can't, we forget things, we get weak in our body. And so progress is not this constant, it's not ever growing, it's not ever existing. Does that make sense? And so we have to recognize that. It's not just something out there, progress, but it's even in our own lives. We think it's happening, but there's something else that's more cyclical, that's more like a circle, that's not a straight line always continuing up. So,
I was gonna summarize that by the fact that you came back to Morocco, even when everyone was saying, why did you come back to Morocco? You're a Muslim in America, so many advantages and blah, blah, blah. And this is why. It's because in this cycle in your life, you found maybe a greater truth for your dynamics today in such an environment, which is a proof also that there is greatness everywhere. And progress is happening in a way everywhere for the inner self. So thank you very much for that, Sidi Ayman. He talked about something I feel very important, the nourishing of the self through scarcity and through sakina and qimat ashiya, the real value of things, which in a way, if we look to make a connection, it's the exact opposite of today's society. You have to be in places very crowded, going super fast, all right, and you have to consume everything. He's talking about scarcity. He's talking about not having too much and having to deal with it. So I found that very, very nourishing. And the main point for you, progress, is know how to handle the transition, failure, frustration, and the different stages of that, which happen a great deal in life. And for you, progress is also one of the consequences of that is never stopping. It's the opposite of being frozen or in a way not moving. So thank you for that. Do we have some questions?
Actually, my question is for Mr. Shiradi. I wanted to hear the part of the story about how he overcame all the obstacles and managed to become a professor. Finally.
Yes. ما بديش كنحس براسي مرتاح وآليز مع النظام التعليمي في المغرب حتى الباك. شكرا. تسعة. Cinquième, sixième, toutes les 3 years. Transition, can I talk about the transition? 3 years. and 3 years. Well, how? There's only one word. Can I follow? Sabr. That's all. Sabr. Sabr. Sabr and effort. دير مجهود. على الأقل ما نوع عندي مشكلة. وفي نفس الوقت تكون كتفكر. حيت كان أقل صار وايز وورز قالوا لي الأستاذ اللي هو الفرنسي ديك الساعة الله يذكره بخير was someone extraordinary ماشي ديال التاسعة التاسعة تاعها أو اللي هي ديال السانكيام قال لي يا ولدي جدك كتهضر فرنسي قلت لي لا ماما كتهضر فرنسي قلت لي لا باباك قلت لي ها قال لي الدار كتهضر فرنسي قلت لي لا قال لي تمحل قلت لي واي قلت لي قال لي انت ماشي في واحد الاسره ولا في واحد البيئه اللي داس عندك تا غون مير اللي لو جورنال اللي ديسكوسيون سون دان نيفو انتيليكتوال سي ال في ما عندكش منين غتلقح باللغه باسكو لونفيرونمون ديالك ني با فرانكوفونيزي صافي خويا بدا في عاديه الفرونسي كيفاش دير قال لي كاين حل اللغه باش تاخذها خاصك تعوم فيها بمعنى خاصك تبقى تسمع الفرنسي بواحد الشكل مستمر وتقرا بواحد الشكل مستمر اللي عاوني الفرنسي وانا خاصني نزول الضحك لان الحاجه من الحوايج اللي عاوني الفرنسي هي الحاجه اللي كنسبوا فيها وكنعيروا فيها وكنسبوا عليها ديما الحموضه سي تو جيم كي سابي دوزان على ليبوك باسكو ديتي انكور بريفاتيزي نهار ناسيوناليزاس مشات عندي جو سي با سي فو رابلي واحد الماجازين اللي كتسمى سيغ لا دو دوزيام كتحط لنا فيه لا بروغراماسيون مونسويال تتخيل دوزيام كتعلمك 25 يوم شنو غدير وداك الشيء هو البورد وما كيزملوش الفرق باسكو دوزيام ايتي جيري باغ دي برو اي دي فغي باسكو دي بون شير فا كنت كنشري لو ماجازين سيغ لا دو وكنتبع البروغرام سا ديماري ا 6 اور دو ماتان افيك دي دوكيمونتير دو كروند كاليتي يا اند افتر ذات كانت كتبدا الامور بوثائقيات إيه من بعد رسوم متحركة and كنت ديما كنقرأ الملخص للأفلام there is a movie this night what is talking about كنت مش نقرأ وكنت تبدا وملي كنت شوف فيه كنت نعود فدوزان كانت خدامة دائما المارش تلفو الكورة كنت تبع التعليق الفرنسية الأفلام الفرنسية المسلسلات الفرنسية وعاد القراءة وعاد الأغاني ديك الساعة كان واحد اختراع ربما تعقلوا عليه ووركمان وا لي بوكس ديك الساعة كان ووركمان راه لا كلاس فا ووركمان والكاسيطة وتسجل ريورايتبل وتسمع فكنت كنعوم في اللغة هذا من كان من الأمور اللي سهلت عليا وأنا دابا أستاذ وكنخدم مع الطلبة ديالي وعندي واحد المادة كنقريها باللغة الإنجليزية وكنلقاو فيها صعوبات نقول لهم ما يمكنش ليكم انتم ما كتعوموش وسط اللغه وتمكنوا منها خاصكم تشوفوا الافلام بالنسخه الاصليه وتسمعوا الاغاني وتقراوا باللغه هو واحد الريفلكس اللي ما بقاش واللي اختفى لسوء الحظ اللي هو واحد الصديق عزيز اللي تواحد ما بقى كيمشي يزورو اللي يسول فيه اللي سميتو ديكشنري نوت الكترونيك بيبر وان ديكشنير كيعاون بواحد الطريقه رهيبه جدا وانه ملي كيدور في راسي ما كنعرفش واحد المعنى واحد لو سونس كنمشي وكنحل وملي كنحل غالبا علاش ديكسيونير زوين هو انه غالبا ملي كتقلب على الكلمه كتشوف الكلمه اللي قبل منها واللي تحت منها كتصدق مالي معاك انت داخل الكلمه كتصدق مالي معاك ثلاثه ولا اربعه هذا الريفلكس هذا ما كاينش في الالكترونيك فهذه القضيه كانت كتعاون من اسباب ايضا التغلب على المشاكل الرفقه الطيبه والرفقه الصالحه جود فريندز they are important in the process they are important بواحد الشكل رهيب حيت لا كنتي مع شي باع مفلسه بس نعم غير هو والعام الاول ديالي ما كانوش عندي اصدقاء بزاف اللي عندها ماني فرانس اولا لانه ثقافيا سا باسي با كان خاصني مده باش نتاقلم وربما كان فيها خير هذا الامر هذا في العام الاول ديالي حتى بديت كنولف شويه بشويه فملي كيكونوا عندك اصدقاء اللي تا هما المخ ديالهم مسطر ومهتمين بالقرايه وبالعلم ولا الدارهم والناس مربين فطبيعه الحال انت هي الانشطه ديالك اللي كدير معاهم تا هما غادي يكون فيهم خير امر واضح اند ديما واحد الرغبه انني نكون واحد حاجه مهمه وكبيره في المشاريع اللي بغينا نديرها، سواء في الخدمه سواء في القرايه سواء المهم باغي ندير شي حاجه. شنو هي الرغبه؟ مازال ما تبنيتش شي حاجه صحيحه. But I'm continuing on the path. What is it? I don't know. But I just had this feeling. Lord, I can't explain it somehow. But I'm gonna make something big happen. بديت الخدمة، بديت المسائل. أنا دابا كنلوح نسموهم اللبنات أو الحجر الأساس ديال بزاف الحوايج. هنا. I don't know what's the shape of things to come. It's gonna be like, but it's gonna come on something.
But excuse me. Can you comment on the what is something big? What meaning did it have for you? Because I think they want to know that. Was it just something big? Oh, I want to make noise. Fait du bruit. No, it is. What does something big mean to you?
It means changing lives for better.
Ah.
Yeah. Changing lives, ديالي وديال الناس اللي دايرين بيا for better. I don't know. It could be a firm. It could be a شركة. يمكن يكون غير عن طريق عملك او استاذ كندير هذا الامر هذا.
So we're talking about service devotion.
Exactly.
Okay.
It's something that would make life of people better كيف ما بغى يكون كيف ما بغى يكون الامر. حتى السيفل سوسايتي كوميتمنت اللي عندي مع الجمعيات اللي انا كنشط فيهم كنحاولوا مثلا في مبادره طارق بن زياد تيزي انا نرفعوا من الوعي السياسي ديال الشباب. وايضا انا حاليا رئيس ديال واحد الجمعيه سميتها سمسم مشاركه مواطنه. عندنا اكبر مشروع ديالي سميتو نوابك بوان ام ار واللي هو ذا فيرست اونلاين ويب سايت اوف فري اند انليميتد كورسبوندنس بين سيتيزنز اند ذير ام بيز بارلمنتري ديبوتيز. سو في الموقع ديال نوابك بوان ام ار تقدر تدخل وتعزل النائب البرلماني اللي مسجل عندنا مفاعل معنا لحد الساعه 55 نائب برلماني اللي قبلوا انهم يلعبوا اللعبه على 395. فتكليك عليه كتشوف تصويرته شنو كيدير اللجنه التشريعيه اللي هو خدام فيها وكطرح لي سؤال كتكتبو بالفرنسيه بالانجليزيه بالعربيه. ولكن تقول لك الانسان كاع امي كيقدر يسجل فيديو ويحطو في الموقع. ف I think that this is a commitment to make people's life better, to install democracy, accountability, and أمور غتحرك إلى الأفضل, making progress somehow, growing things. I'm just like a little farmer throwing grains, وكتلوح البذور هنا وهنا وهنا وهنا, waiting for the good rain, waiting for the good sun, waiting for the good wind to make the crops grow. Something like that. I don't know.
Barakallahu
feek. Was it?
Very insightful. Barakallahu feek. Yes, please. Any other question, please? Tfadlo. This is your time.
Hello. My question is for you, Ms. Mian and Ms. Murat. You talked about how you were living in America because you were born in America. You had the material side of the life. You have all the choices, and you talk about the feeling of your soul, about how you couldn't find your path, your way in life. But for us, like Moroccans and general Maghrebins, youth, we don't have this much opportunities in life. So we can't really be like see ourselves in your experience, because you were lucky if you were in the top of the list and you didn't find your way, so you have the choice to get back. But us, we are not in the not far away from you, but as we are not in better position like you was in America. So how could we Moroccans find our way in life like you did? Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mandy. Well, you can be fair. It's a good question, and I don't know if you're familiar with the word privilege, but this is a word that's very important right now in contemporary American culture. And you're right. I'm white. I'm a man. I'm healthy. Alhamdulillah. I'm from a middle-class family, and so I have the privilege to think about my soul and to have that be important to me, to be a priority that I can focus on that. And I recognize that for someone, I mean, Sidi Ayman, his family is slightly different because they chose to go live in Oman, but I'm sure there are a lot of families that have to live in situations where they don't have water, where they don't have electricity. It's not a
choice.
They don't have a choice, like you're mentioning about choices. And all I can say is that, you know, you're going to need, as Moroccans, you have to find your way, and you have to find a balance between progress in terms of the dunya we sense and trying to make things better, but don't lose yourself. Don't forget about your soul. Don't forget about, you know, your relationship to Allah, because we're all going to die. You know, that's the reality, is our lives are short. And, you know, we do what we can for our society. I mean, I run a school now in Marrakesh. We have taqriban 70 shakhs kikhdem ma'ana. Ana farhan kul shahr kinkhalsom wa kinqul alhamdulillah. Subhanallah, kinshuf nas kitzawju kiwlidu wa subhanallah wahd rizq halal. What more progress can you ask for than to be able to help people to do something like that, to have families? And so we don't forget about that, but also don't see that as the only goal, because I mean the dunya is empty. I'm American, and now we just elected this man, Donald Trump, to be our president. And it's...
You didn't, come on.
Well, I mean, I didn't personally, but we did. And it's a sign of... It's a sign that you can't continue progress forever. I mean, I think these are the questions that seem to be raised today, is that, you know, this idea that we're going to always be better and better and better, it's not true. It's not. And so I think that, alhamdulillah, as young Moroccans, you know the expression in English, count your blessings. In the Quran, right? Ni'matullahi la tuhsuha. That there are a lot of beautiful things here. And to just because, you know, things might be a little better in Europe or a little better in the United States, it doesn't mean things are bad here. Alhamdulillah. I mean, people come from Africa, sub-Saharan African countries to Morocco, and they say, Subhanallah, this is great. You guys have you have security. Alhamdulillah. I mean, we have a safety. We have good, you know, you have schools, you have families, you have mothers and fathers who love you. You know, we have, we can practice our religion, we can find jobs. Alhamdulillah, it's not that bad. Alhamdulillah. So that's, you know, but it's a struggle to find both and to balance between, you know, working in this way and working in this way. But don't give up on either one. That's the only advice I can give. If either of you would like to comment.
Do you want to say something? I have something.
something to add on that? Just quickly, because we, even though our paths are different, having lived in France, the US, and Morocco, I can relate to something he said before. And it's a kind of a summary of the two experiences, where they're linked. He was in a place where they didn't have much. But for I'm pretty sure, I'm going to do a guess on this. I'm pretty sure that for the three of us, if you give us the opportunity right now to go to such a place, would we turn that off? We would jump on such an opportunity, because for us now, who live in such crowded places, a lot of noise, a lot of fitna everywhere, especially in the big cities, Casablanca, even more so than Marrakesh and Rabat and Fez and so on. To go to a very quiet place, you don't have much, you can help a lot of people, you can give them aim, knowledge. To teach a language to someone, to teach mathematics to someone who doesn't have access to that, this is a wonderful ajr, especially when you don't have much. But at the same time, as an American, yeah, it's true that they have all the commodities, but you have to know that for the Americans who are seeking the truth, many more, a lot of them just like you, they come to Morocco just to visit, for example, the old shrines of Awliya. They come thousands of miles, and some of them even stay here, like for knowledge, like Titus Vercart, Rahimahullah, Martin Lings, Fridjof Schion, Rahmatullah Alayhim, all these great scholars have the same, just as the Americans have some very, you know, like things acquired, everything is acquired, the, you know, social service and the food and Walmart and everything. We also have this. Yeah, I have the tajin, OMG, Hatana. No, it's true. You don't know it, but I'm just reminding you. You have things that people cross the whole world to come experience. Go tell a person from Ethiopia or Senegal to come to the shrine of Sidi Ahmed Tijani, rahmatullah alayhi, and look at the eyes, how they're going to go. And it's just an example. It can be for something else. You can come for Al-Qarawiyin, you can come for the monuments, you can come for something else. He came, Sheikh Hamza Yusuf came to Morocco just to learn Arabic. So, what I'm saying is that I think there is a case to be made for how much, just like he said, we were taking pictures while opening the water. How much are we appreciating what we have in Morocco? And I am pretty sure that, but just between you and I, I'm sure Sidi Hamza appreciates the things we have in Morocco even more so than I do. So what about you? You see, and it gives you another perspective on things. I think progress, as we said, can be made everywhere, right? Can be experienced. Tasted everywhere.
إضافة بسيطة اللي كنت في سلطنة عمان وجينا المغرب. اللي جينا المغرب اكتشفت واحد المجموعة ديال الظواهر يعني تسول وسرقة شرائين. فبحكم أن هادو هما جوج ديال المرجعيات اللي كنعرف the two backgrounds عماني cultural background Moroccan cultural background comparing the two كنقول أن الشعب المغربي ما مزياش لأنه عندي شنو؟ لأنه عندي باكغراوند واحد سميتو سلطان العمان الشعب المغربي ما مزياش حيت ديما كنقارن مع حاجة وحدة حيت هي اللي عندي من بعد والله خديت الباك ديالي وكملت القراية ديالي وخدمت وجاوني فرص فين سافرت في العمل سافرت وشوف داخل المغرب راه عالم مصغر بالمناطق ديالنا و الدايفرسيتي اللي كاينه كنشوف مختلف انواع الناس وانت كتعرف انه كاين مزيان كاين اللي مزيانش كما كنقولوا بالدارجه ديالنا بنادم حجر وطوب مختلف اللي خرج من المغرب وشوف دول اخرى في افريقيا جنوب الصحراء في اوروبا رجع للشرق الاوسط تيسرت الامور بسبب الخبره في العمل الجمعوي انني رجعت تما كنخدم مستشار سيتو في الشؤون ديال الشباب والعمل الجمعوي رجعت تما مع الكويت ومع قطر وزاره الشباب تما عندهم لبنان فاكتشفت من ما احتكيت مع هاد الناس ومع حتى غير ما نهضروا بيان سور بدول الخليج راك ساكن في نفس الوقت عندك احتكاك مباشر وغير منقطع مع الثقافه الهنديه والباكستانيه والبنغاليه والسريلانكيه اللي كاينه تما
سير مور
كومبليكيتد. فما عرفتش ان المغربي واحد انسان رائع جدا والثقافه المغربيه ثقافه رائعه جدا، ثقافه التسامح، ثقافه يقدر المغربي يحقد عليك ويحسد عليك ولكن شورت ران بقيك قدام. يقدر المغربي حنا اللي حاجه وحيده اللي عندنا شويه ما مزيانهش هو انه عندنا الثقافه ديال لوبورتونيزم، الثقافه ديال الهوزه ديال الهمزه ديال الدجاجه الكمونه طير بها اي وقت قطع عينك انت انا قريب منك هذه عندنا مي سي با موفي. ملي كتشوف شنو كيوقع في دول اخرى وفي ثقافات اخرى راه صراحه ملي غتخرج من المغرب وغتجيب واحد الندوه بحال هذه اللي غتطلب ان شاء الله وفي الندوه بحالها وغتطرح سؤال غادي يكون سؤال مغاير تماما من السؤال اللي طرحتي دابا حيت غادي تكون اكتشفتي امور اخرى غتعرف انه if you think that we have less that we don't have much opportunities right in fact you have many ملي كتقارن مع امور اخرى خاص غير تعدد المرجعيات ديالك دابا بعد ان شاء الله تكبر شويه كل مولع في السفر تكتشف بلاد المغرب تكتشف غير مناطق مختلفه من المغرب تكتشف واحد امور اخرى امور اخرى وتكتشف انه داخل المغرب there are really people with less opportunities and less بزاف الامور بلا ما يحتاجوا انني نمشيو لعند الامريكان باش نقارن مع امريكي نقارن مع المغاربه اصلا والفهم انه شوف الله سبحانه وتعالى كيقولها كتاب الحكيم راه وفطرنا بعضكم على بعض في الرزق it's life. شوف ما كاينش شي واحد غادي يدوز extreme poverty all his life خبره التجربه ديالي وخمسه ديال الفرق جاب ما كاينش شي واحد غادي يدوز extreme wealth all his life. Life is a sinuswood of path كيقراو العلوم الفيزيائيه ستافاكو سينيسويدا كيطلع فيها مرة عندك مرة ما عندكش مرة ميسر مرة مخنوق مرة you have money مرة you don't life goes on هي مراحل وفي مرحلة اللي كتقول انه ما عنديش غتجي مع اخر غادي يكون فيها عندك امور ترجع ما عندكش امور تكون عندك that's life you learn انه الامور تبقى غادية هذه المسائل هذه وتصير as كتفوت and it all goes so no fixed position for الامور everything changes with time. And maybe with Donald Trump, the head of the U.S. hierarchy of power, maybe we're going to assist in 10 or 20 years a very viral and strong migration movement from U.S. to Morocco in the years to come. There are no guarantees.
By the way,
there are no guarantees.
The figures are higher and higher from year to year of people of North America who
coming
to Morocco.
So,
yeah.
So, yeah.
You've probably heard the hadith where the Prophet, peace be upon him, he said, if the son of Adam had a mountain of gold, he just wants another one. And it's real. Yeah, I'm sure on Facebook you've seen the little video where the guy who doesn't have any legs sees a person walking and says, oh, I wish I could just walk. And the person walking sees somebody on a bicycle and says, oh, I wish I had a bike. And the person on the bike sees a car. Oh, I wish I had a car. And then the guy in the car sees a nicer, a fancier car, a better car. And I mean, I know this for myself. I moved to Morocco and I lived in a little apartment with my family. And we just wished that we could have a little more space, a bigger house. We moved, alhamdulillah, we moved to a bigger house. And then I thought, oh, I wish I had like a little villa, like a petite villa. So we moved to a petite villa. And now we live in a petite villa. And in the next neighborhood, they have big villas. And I go for a walk sometimes with my kids. Oh, I wish we had a big villa. There's no end. And so what we realize is that the only what we have control over is our mind. And our heart and our perspective. And so what we have to deal with is that, you know, that the greed and the tamah that comes in, and we have to learn to deal with it. And then, inshallah, if we can reach where Sidi Ayman is, where we want to help other people, where we start to turn our attention, how do we help other people succeed? How do we help other people get more and become and to grow and develop? So that's inshallah where we can go.
First of all, Assalamu alaikum. Thank you. Thank you, the three of you, for your very inspiring stories and anecdotes. Well, I have a question for both of you. I mean, first of all, Mr. Hamza, I mean, if you haven't came to Morocco for many years ago, would you be the same person? I mean, would you convert to Islam? Would you be inspired the same way you are right now? And it's almost the same question for you. If you haven't been in those hardships and living in Oman for many years and suffering for no water and electricity, would you be the same, Mr. Amos, right? Mr. Amos sitting there talking to us and sharing your experiences with us. I mean, most shortly, my question is that, do you believe in reasons? I mean, being right here in this moment, how would I say it? Just, yeah, as bad. I mean, just the reason, things happen for a reason. Whenever happen, I mean, if you just walk and you scramble on thought, does it happen for a reason? Do you believe in this?
I think that I'm gonna be the same person I am right now if I, if I haven't spent my childhood in Sultanate of Oman. That's for sure. لأن كل تجربة في الحياة كتخلي واحد البصمة ديالها على الشخصية ولا الأفكار ولا المعايير الأخلاقية ولا نظرة الحياة ولا بزاف الأمور. ف of course we have no control over some things. ما عندكش. You go through them, you experience them, and they make you who you are. شوف سبحان الله المكوث ديالنا في سلطنة عمان لمدة 10 سنوات الأمور اللي تعلمت أولا بعد الغنى الثقافي حتى أنه في سلطنة عمان ما كانش على العمانيين جنسية كما بحال دول الخليج عندك بنغلاديش الهنود الباكستانيين فكنا كنخرجوا الزنقة كنلعبوا مع وليداتهم كنباتوا عند بعضياتنا كل مرة عند الدار فغنى ثقافي هذا الغنى الثقافي والغنى اللغوي لأنني جبت معايا العربية واللونجلي من سلطنة عمان مزيان بزاف فرنساوية هنا هاد اللونجلي اللي غتوقف معايا بواحد الطريقة رهيبة جدا في الصعود المهني ديالي في الخدمة الأولى ديالي بالخدمة الثانية اللونجلي كانوا من الأسباب اللي خلوني علاش تخاليت وهي فاش بديت التجربة ديالي في الموارد البشرية في الـ HR في الهيومن ريسورسز لأن الشركة الأولى اللي خدمت فيها شركة دولية ومن الامور اللي سهلت عليا نحضر الميتينغز and to advance in my junior professional career ديك الساعه it was English. English would have been something maybe I would be good at as good as I wasn't in سلطنة عمان. الباساج ديالي في عمان هو اللي خلى انه طور فيا بزاف ديال الحوايج اللي كيعاونوني اليوم من هدف كل راحة. واحدة من الخاصيات ديالي عاودت ثاني ربما Maybe my wife here can, Miriam can confirm that. Because, Juliet, you don't panic so much.
Yes.
So, when you have a problem, or 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 a كنت بتلعب شوية كنت بتلعب شوية بيكن باور بيكن باور واو هذا خصك كونفرنس تروح حدا ذا اكسبريشن بيكن باور واز لايك ذا great one of the greatest German players ever
soccer player
and he was like the captain of Western Germany and he was a great defender playing defense And his style was quiet, calm,
Beware of the sweeping water.
Oh,
we have a soccer lover here.
Yeah. and so when we say for something big and bad, someone who means slows down the game, thinks really carefully, don't play very, someone's taking his time in building actions. هذا الامر هذا كان اعتقد بان تجربه ديال السويح زرعات الخليه شي حرف طريقه الشخصيه ديالي حيت السويح شي مرات كتبغي بغيت شي مرات تضحكوا شويه كون جيت للمغرب وعاد مشيت للسويح كنت غنمشي غنتمنى نشوف شي جوج ديال الضعبه نتمنى نشوف شي مضاربه نتمنى نشوف الصداع الغوت شي حاجه الهيلالا ما كاينش هادشي راه سي طالب السويد ديال السويد كان واحد الهدوء رهيب واحد الصمت واللي واحد الصمت الا طولتي فيه شويه ربما يؤدي الى الحكمه واحد الناحيه فهاد الامر هذا كان صافي كيك شوز في الشخصيه ديالي اللي اليوم هي من 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 السمات ديالي يعني فيس it does have an effect and I wouldn't be the same person that I am today if I haven't been to سلطنة عمان. هذا أمر لا غبار عليه ولا نقاش كل شيء كيتسرع وعدم الحكم على الثقافات وعلى المظاهر لأن سلطنة عمان كنا كنباتوا عند بعضياتنا كان آخر واحد مرة كنا كنبانوا عند شيفان الهندوسي كيصبح على 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 رادا وكريشنا والعافية والطبعة ويتعبد شوية بهذيك النار ومرة نباتوا عند الأردني صديقنا ومرة نباتوا عند الياباني وتمثال ديال البودا ومرة نباتوا عند فكبرت في واحد البيئة ديال التسامح زعما واحد الغنى مهم جدا اللي هو أيضا أنت هو عاوتاني كيخلف واحد الحاجة في الشخصية ديالك من بعد اللي كتبان ف everything is linked ما غاديش نكونوا في الديترمينيزم ولكن غادي نكونوا في أنه شوف الإنسان مخير فيما يعلم مسير فيما لا يعلم إذا خرجت الصباح عندي السيارة ديالي في ديماري شديت الطريق درت كسيدة وقعت شي آفة إذا الكسيدة وقعت بسبب سائد الفران العجلات عيالي الحالة الميكانيكية للسيارة صعيب علي أنني نقول بأن الأمر قضاء الله قدر بعد الأمر أنا مكتوب الله مسير فيه لا It's my fault. خطأ ديالي. الحالة الميكانيكية للسيارة محسوبة عليا. أنا مخير فيما أعلم. وهذيك الحاجة أنا عندي عليها لما وعندي عليها الكنترول وعندي عليها التدخل. On the other hand, إلى ديماريت سيارتي وخرجت الصباح شديت الطريق. محترم الأمور وريحتي ناضية، طوموبيلتي ناضية، كلشي مزيان، ما عليا والو. وصائق متهور. جاو هو اللي خلق الانساب وضربني من الدور، ضربني من الجن وتسبب لي في الآفة. أنا مسير فيما لا أعلم. This is something that قضاء وقدر مكتوب الله. مكتوب الله هذيك الساعة. مكتوب الله ماشي ملي حنا كنديرو هذي دراستنا. مكتوب الله هذيك الساعة. نحن مخيرون فيما نعلم، مسيرون فيما لا نعلم. والمشي لعمان it was 3 years old.
I think we have to recognize that everything that happens in our life it has a reason. That it has an effect on who we are. There's a great talk, if you want, by Steve Jobs, who passed away, called Connecting the Dots. Connecting the Dots. And he talks about his own life, about creating Apple Computers, the Apple company, and how, what things that he did when he was young, that he didn't know why, but then later, they helped him in his life. And I think that's the most important thing at your age now is that you don't know exactly where you're going to be in 10 years, 20 years, but you have choices that you can make now about building the foundation. And so whether it's learning English, I mean, it's a very valuable language, whether it's about having good friends, you know, making decisions about where you go, you know, with your, you know, the EU, very important. They're very important. And when you have them, you need to learn from them. You need to welcome them and use those for, you know, and not run away from them. So that's one thing that I would say is to you know, when you have those moments where you don't know why you're doing something, you don't know what's happening, trust and turn to Allah and ask, you know, what am I supposed to do here? And like Sidi Ayman said, work hard, you know, do what you need to keep going, keep going. So I just, you know, I think that's it. And every one of you will experience it. Sorry. Every person is going to have difficulty in your life.
We ourselves will still have many others.
Yeah, well, it's still coming. Exactly. And those are, they're important times. They're not, you know, it's kind of, what's his name? Beckenbauer.
Beckenbauer.
Stay calm, and, you know, keep going in those moments, you know. You know, so that, I just think that's an important thing to remember also.
Does someone else have a question? Please.
Donc la première chose, c'est que quand on parle de progrès, je crois qu'il est très important de parler de repères, parce que.
When she says that when you talk about progress, first and foremost, you have to talk about. Yeah, benchmark. I think is a good one. Yeah, like reference key points.
Parce que ce qui est progrès, par exemple, pour nous, en tant que musulmans, est différent par rapport à quelqu'un qui a été dans une culture moderne aux États-Unis ou dans quelque part d'autre.
Because what progress means for us Muslims is very different for people who lived in other cultures like Americans and so on.
Et donc, ce qui est très important, c'est définir le référentiel et le repère pour aller de l'avant et pour progresser. Et donc, la deuxième chose, c'est que M. Boyette disait toujours qu'on avait deux voies. C'est soit de s'inscrire dans la tendance, soit de prendre position par rapport à ce qui se passait.
Attends. Deux secondes. So, she says that she makes a connection with her, basically her classes with Sidi Boyette, and she says that for being able to go forward starts with having the how can you say this? A good foundation, but based on like common references, universal references. Et ensuite, tu disais justement la deuxième idée, comme il disait.
Donc, comme il disait, c'est soit on peut s'inscrire dans la tendance.
Okay. So either you are within the dynamics of the tendencies of your time.
Soit qu'on prend position par rapport à ce qui se passe.
Or we take action in reaction to what is to what is happening.
Et donc le défi et ma question, c'est comment autant avoir une position par rapport à ce qui se passait et de continuer à progresser. Parce que maintenant le progrès, c'est question de tendance, s'inscrire dans la tendance et progresser. Maintenant c'est comment prendre une position et en même temps continuer à progresser dans ce aspect.
So how can you at the same time have an opinion, a position within the context and at the same time take action? Redis la fin de ta phrase parce qu'elle était longue.
Donc c'est comment avoir une position par rapport à ce qui se passe, okay, et continuer à progresser,
and
avoir le sens de progresser.
Oh, okay. And so yeah, and doing the both at the same time. How can you do both at the same time within your context and the tendencies of your time, being able to take action and keep progressing through these actions.
Donc et la deuxième intervention, c'est que je crois que maintenant le modernisme, donc le modernisme a influencé notre notion de progrès. Et donc.
And now she says, this is a second thought or question. Modernism has affected our way of thinking today, nowadays.
Oui. Et donc le progrès, c'est toujours question d'aller dans, aller. Donc c'est progresser, aller de l'avant. Et donc there is no connections with the roots and tradition.
Severe. The connections, yes, with the roots and traditions, yes, were severe at a certain point in time, because as you said, you know, earlier about going, yes, it's forgetting about the present, okay?
Et puis maintenant, on arrive à un moment où on ne comprend plus vers où on va. Et donc, I want you to talk about this connection with the roots and traditions and the importance of this connection to go forward.
Yes, because she says we don't know, we don't understand, we don't consider the importance of where is it that we're going to. What is the goal? So you have two questions. Is that all right? Do you want me to remind you, or is it fine? Okay.
Merci.
Tu vas te lâcher.
Thank you for your question. The fact that you asked the question means that you know the answer. I think recognizing the problem inside of it is the answer. Definitely is part of the solution. Understanding the way in which there's been a cut from the roots, and these kinds of things. I'll say two things. The first one is, I'd like to look at the word consumerism. How would you say that in Arabic? Because I think this is a key issue, is that we've become a consumer society. And when I say this, I think Sidi Ayman experienced it with his family when they lived with nothing, and you experience simplicity. You realize what consumerism is. But I want to look at it from a different perspective. I want to look at it from the perspective of these. Is that we've become, especially as youth, that we've started to become people who consume information. When we want to listen to music, when we want music in our lives, we put little things in our ears, and we consume it. When we talk about spirituality and religion, we go to the masjid, or we go and we turn on Iqra, and we consume it. And I want to challenge you to be people who start to produce it. Where you want some music in your life? Let's sing. Let's make music together. You know, learn an instrument. Have something where you can, if you're with your friends, that you can play a little guitar. You can sing a song for them. You can give something. In your relationships with people, try not to be people who are consuming all the time, are taking. How do you give? And I don't know if this is answering your question, but I think that this is a very important part of this question as we move forward in terms of progress, because the world, we can't continue to be consumers. If we all live lives like Americans in terms of consuming, if the Chinese and in India become consumers like Americans, we're in trouble. We're gonna destroy the earth. And so we have to find ways to stop this eating of everything and start to think about producing. Also, as you know, when you think about work options for yourself in the future, try to think about ways that you can create jobs for people, that you can be a producer of things rather than always a consumer. So that's one thing. The second question about where are we going? You've probably all heard of Machiavelli, right? And there's the Machiavellian, this idea that the ends justify the means. So if we have a good goal, we can do anything to reach it.
Yeah, she says that Mr. Boyette, he's their yeah. teacher, and she says he tells them the good end justifies the right or the good means.
Right, and what we have to recognize also as Muslims is that our end is not in this world. And our end is somewhere else. وَإِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ. You know, that's the end. And so we have to recognize that's... So when we ask the question, why, what's the purpose of all this? In modern, you know, what's the goal? We have to be very careful. We have to find our goal. Because if we just follow, if we just, you know, do whatever is the latest moda and, you know, follow, whether it's politically, economically, socially, spiritually, religiously, if we just follow, we're in trouble. Because that's what I mean by consumerism, that we just, because...
it's becoming sheep like cattle.
Ooh, and it's really a type of death. And so I would encourage, again, Dickenbauer, you know, slow down. Don't, you know, I like it, you know. And figure out, where are you going? What's your goal in life? And don't, you know, the Prophet, peace be upon him, he said at the end of time, the person sitting is better than the person standing. The person standing is better than the person walking. The person walking slowly, Dickenbauer, is better than the person running. You know, so this is a time where you have to slow down and figure out what your goal is. What is your personal goal? What is your family goal? What is your communal goal? And then work toward it. Because this is the problem, is that our modern modernity is telling us that we don't need to answer the question why. We just have to do it faster and better, and it doesn't, and bigger, you know, and make more money, but they don't want to talk about why. And that's, I think, and I think that's why we're here together tonight, is to raise the value of the question why. In all of this. So.
Could I add just one thing before giving the microphone to Sidi Ayman? Because he quoted that hadith. There's another one I love. At-ta'anni min ar-Rahman wal-ajalatu min ash-shaytan. Patient deliberation or reflection is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ar-Rahman. And haste is from shaytan. So what he's saying is brilliant, because he's basically saying what is happening right now, taking a moment to stop and just consider, first of all, who am I, what is happening, how am I related to what is happening, and what do I want to do with all these elements? What is happening tonight, we don't do this enough with our minds and our hearts. And you know what? I've studied the media management, communications, and so on. The people who manufacture the smartphones, the TVs, the ads, they don't want you to stop. You are created for, I do the link with what they're saying, creating, helping people, creating jobs, teaching. You were created for ibadah. What is ibadah? Love, devotion, brotherhood, service. All the tariqas of Islam, all the madahib, everything, even in the other great religions, work for devotion. But today, as he says, it's, I just need to, I'm very sorry, it's a very vulgar expression, and this is why, by the way, Hamza Yusuf says, this is why you have more and more obese people today. There has never been on the face of the earth at any time in the history of civilization before so many obese and ugly persons. Subhanallah. So there's a relationship.
The second question. She was saying that the tradition, the link with the tradition and the history and the roots were severe at a certain point of time, and we don't know where is it we're going to. What's the goal? How can we reach the goal? Is it?
This is where I join the ideas of. So many wise people, and a glimpse of that was shared just right now by both of you. Il casso fu duo, buia, zato duo. Per promuovere la di e para Smith, che ne duo va bene, too much fog. So the only healthy and rational reflex is that you slow down, because you have no. It's a policy, it was a sight. But eventually, if you're in the red, if you had a life wrong, the repair, I don't see it. So you slow down. Take him out. When you slow down, and accept a range of sight you have, at the range of the sight you have, according to it, should be also the speed by which you're going in life. And the رؤية واضحة. I can go faster. I don't know where I'm going. Take it easy. على حساب الرؤية ديالي، على حساب السرعة ديالي. It's like driving the car. طريق واضحة كل شيء بيننا في الكروز 120. ضبابة 4 ايام. سيب شوية عليك. الضبابة خلعتك. لكن راه تبقى ديك عارف الشوافية مزيان. كتلصق ورا شي ربوك. حيت ربوك. Big trucks. Because they're high. They have a better sight than you have in your small car. So you stuck behind a big truck and you follow the lead. They have the interest of having a mentor. They have the interest of having a mentor. Someone who would show you the way somehow. Someone who would drive you through times of fog. Yeah, and someone who have enough wisdom to see above the fog and see the clear things and tell you, just stay behind me, I'm gonna drive you through the things. But you're still driving your car. Ramishimot Asistana is not driving your car, you are driving your car, you're just following the lead. But it's still your own vehicle, your own purpose, your own things. And when the fog disappears, اش كيدير مور الموك؟ كيدير لك السينيال على اليمين بمعنى كوا سيف. Now you can go. So إلا ما عندكش الغوبير، إلا ما عرفتش كنت هذاك الغوبير، slow down and find a wise person in your community, a wise person in your family, a wise friend, someone to which we can go through in times of trouble to seek counseling, to seek wisdom, to seek insights, to seek breakthroughs, sometimes to seek nothing, just silence, peace. Peace because it's too much noisy in my brain. I have too much ideas firing, mixing inside my brain. I don't see clearly anymore. So that's the advice I can give about your question. واكثر من ذلك ان المرجعيه عندنا في المغرب هي اكثر تخليطه من المرجعيه المشرقيه. والامر راه ممكن تفقد الدستور المغربي بالروافد الاسلاميه الافريقيه العربيه الصحراويه الحسانيه اليهوديه. فالروافد عندنا كثر ولي غوبي عندنا في المغرب كاينين كثر. و الترانزيشن اللي كنمروا منها حنايا عندنا دي فاكتور كيعاونوا فيها وانه هو هذا الغنى اللي عايشين فيه اكثر من دول اخرى. ف ملي ما كتبقاش عارف كتحس بواحد كاينه واحد شحال امين معلوف في زيدون تاع الخياع ملي كتحس بهذاك الشرح انه كاين نصيحه لا تقدم على اي مشاريع كبرى في حياتك حتى تحل الصوره. لانه ما يمكنش لك الديماج ولا ما كاينش امه او دوله او شعب او انسان قطع اشواط وحقق انجازات عظمى هو مازال عايش تحت ازمه هويتيه كبيره. ما كاينش هذا الامر. هذا خاصو يتحل. باش كيتحل؟ كل واحد بطريقته. There is no recipe. There is no. It's not rational. It's not so much about that. ماشي sounds exact. And to promise a hero, then cut what I'm so and I know who I am, and I know what I'm going to do in life, and I know, and I know. هو هو واحد المسار حياتي كنت في كل إنسان طريقة خاصة من أهم كما قلت بهذيك الأنالوجية السوغان. Find a mentor, a leader, a wise person, but keep driving your own vehicle. أنا مسؤول على اختياراتك ومسؤول على مسائلك. إذا كان شيء إضافة أخرى نقدر نضيفها في إطار البحث عن صورة أفضل ووجهة أفضل واتضاح صورة الرفع من معدلات القراءة ديالك. الرفع من معدلات القراءة. الرفع
عندنا الرصيد المعرفي، الرصيد المعرفي الرفع ديالو بصفة دائمة ومستمرة كيعاونك أنك تحل هذا المشكل الهوياتي في طرف وجيز، في طرف وجيز. معدلات القراءة وكنعرفوا الإحصائيات وخرجت من عند وزارة الثقافة، يا حسرة هذه نبقى واحد شهرين ولا ثلاث شهور، معدلات القراءة في المغرب عارفين شحال؟ جوج دقائق في العام، المغربي كيقرا جوج دقائق في السنة، ربما تكون عوض واحد المر الواقع ديال الضوء، مي كيقرا شي حاجة بعدها جوج دقائق في العام. رفع معدلات القراءة أمر مهم جدا، لأنه ملي كنقراو المفكرين وكتاب وناس رسموا أنه الحل وحل إشكاليات كبيرة تمروا منها هوياتية وفلسفية وأخلاقية وكل شيء، راه كاينة في الرف وكاينة في واحد أربعة الصفحات في واحد الكتاب مغبر مسدود عليه في شي بلاصة. It's there where you find a glimpse of الحل اللي كاين عندك. وعلاش القراءة أهم من المشاهدة؟ حكم هذا عدم العدد ديال الشباب هنايا وأنا أستاذ، هو القضية اللي كنديرها مع الطلبة ديالي السي بوعيد غير فهمي. كنقول الشم اللي كتهز ورقة وكتقراها أحسن من أنني نشوف وثائقي.